Morning. Welcome to the online classes of RCA Education Hub Bansu. Let's continue class 12th biology, chapter number 8th, mineral nutrition in plants. So before that we discuss about the nitrogen, phosphorus and calcium. Now let's discuss about the three main nutrients which are required by the plants. So let's start. Potassium. It is mainly absorbed by the plants in the form of potassium ion. Okay. These are known as quality nutrients as very important for the plants. It also play important role in opening and closing of the stomata, as we discuss about this in a K positive ion transport hypothesis, that how the influx and efflux of the K positive ion play important role in opening and closing of stomata. Okay. It is also essential or the main component or play vital role in cation neutralization. Okay, membrane transport. It means if the any protein, nutrients or any solute or solvent molecules can be transported from through the membrane, then it is also useful. Okay, it is also play vital role in enzyme activation. Okay, for different metabolic activities. As well as it also play important role in osmotic potential. Okay, in increasing or ever in maintaining the osmotic potential. Deficiency symptoms. What happen? Deficiency symptoms is causes scorching and curling of the leaf tip. Okay, it means the leaves became bent down. Okay, so that is caused due to the deficiency of potassium. Chlorosis, as leaves become yellowish in color due to the lacking of potassium. It also reduces plant growth, seed and fruit development too. It reduces the protein synthesis also. So these are the deficiency symptoms of potassium. Now let's go ahead and discuss about the magnesium. Magnesium mainly present in the soil in the form of dolomite. Okay. It's in the form of MgCO3.CaCO3 or in the form of carbonate MgCO3. Okay, it is the main component of ring structure of chlorophyll. If later on we discuss about the structure of chlorophyll, so it is the main component of ring structure of chlorophyll. It also play vital role in joining the two subunits of ribosomes as well as of RNA too. It activates the enzymes of respiration and photosynthesis, as well as it also helpful in the synthesis of RNA ribonucleic acid and DNA deoxyribonucleic acid. Now let's discuss about the deficiency symptoms of magnesium. Then it causes interveinal chlorosis. Okay, interveinal chlorosis. So these are the venal or midribs of the leaves. So they become yellowish in color, due to which transportation of substance should be stopped and complete leaves become yellow in color. It reduces the rate of photosynthesis. As we discussed, because it activates the enzymes of photosynthesis. So when enzymes are not activated, then it retards the rate of photosynthesis. Due to the dominance of anthocyanin pigments, leaves show different pigmentations which are of reddish, yellowish or orange in color. Okay, now let's discuss about the sulfur, next element. It is absorbed by the plant in the form of sulfate ion. Okay, it is absorbed by the plants in the form of sulfate ion, and some plants or it is absorbed through the leaves in the gaseous form, sulfur dioxide. It provides pungent smell to the cruciferae family. We know that member of cruciferae family having pungent smell, for example onion, okay, garlic, they having some specific smell. Okay, by smelling them we identify that these are onion or garlics. So that pungent smell is due to the presence of sulfur. It also play important role in synthesis of amino acids or protein. Amino acid combined to form protein. It is the main component of vitamin B1, okay, and coenzyme A, which also play vital role in different metabolic activities of the plants. the deficiency symptoms of sulfur. One is chlorosis, okay, same as the leaves become yellowish in color or damage to the chlorophyll takes place. Plant growth retarded, so the height of the plant became dwarf or stunted growth. Stem became woody due to the formation of sclerenchymatous tissue. Understand? The stem became woody or hard. Okay, so these are the deficiency symptoms of sulfur. Okay, students.